Yellow. So this is an update on stuff. Yesterday was very interesting. Let's see. I think I realized something yesterday, that when I have those days of really, really big, strong attacks, that I think they might actually be starting in my sleep. Two nights ago, I was dreaming and dreaming, but the dreams were like what happens during my seizures. And that they're very vivid and detailed, so much, and then they have that weird feeling along with them as well. That sickening, dreadful kind of feeling. And I was having these dreams two nights ago, or they're in the morning, I don't know when they were, but they really emotional. There's another one. Extremely emotional dreams, the same kind of way I feel after a seizure happens. My little girl woke me up in the morning during one, or maybe after one, I don't know. And I'm like, oh no, it's gonna happen. It was really bad. Just the way I felt was exactly like those days when I'm just going to be having them all day long, super strong, especially in the morning, and then they kind of get better, but they don't go away for 2 days maybe, or three, but the strong ones only last for the first day. And I was having these dreams, and I'm like waking up to my little girl waking me up, and I'm like, oh no, she woke me up when I was dreaming. This is how I used to think of it, is if someone woke me up during these really vivid, detailed dreams, I would be screwed up for the rest of the day. That's how I would think about it. But now I'm starting to think that I'm actually having these seizures during my sleep. And that's why I'm waking up feeling so strange and having all these flashbacks and visions from my dreams and these really weird detailed parts of them, just like during an attack. There's certain very detailed things that don't make any sense, but they're there, but they make me feel sick. Like, for an example, what was I doing? In this dream or whatever, there was like a box of, it was a jewelry box or just a box of trinkets, I don't know, and I opened it in the dream and it was just so detailed. And then there was like a sandwich bag of moldy food, and then there was books or something? I don't know, that's all I can remember. But the way it happens is that in the dream, while I was sleeping, it's the exact same feeling doing that, opening that box and going through this stuff. It's hard to explain. It's the exact same feeling as when I'm awake and a seizure hits. And so that's why I'm starting to think that I've been having these in my sleep as well. So it's been since August, and this is October, so August, September. It's only been 3 months since my last really bad big ones. And I don't know if it's a fall or what. I don't know, maybe I always have them this regularly. I just don't ever, well, this is the first time I've ever documented it, so I'm really trying to pay attention to them this time. But, okay, great. Okay. These little carbamazepines are what stopped them yesterday. I'm 99.9% sure that those drugs are working. And I've been on them a little over a week now, and yesterday was gonna be bad. It was gonna be a bad day. I could feel it when I woke up, and I was scared. And I stayed in my room just waiting for something to happen because I could feel it. It's like a build up, you know? And my whole body just felt anxious and sick. And I just felt like it was gonna be bad. It was so familiar. This is exactly how it is. But they didn't happen like they usually do. And I'm pretty sure it's the medication. And I'm confused by it. It's the first time ever that I've woken up like that without having massive earthquake shattering kind of seizures. It has to be the medication. It just has to be. So yesterday was still a bit hard because I was emotional, and it's, I get really emotional when these things are happening. It's like nothing is sad. I'm scared, but there's really nothing to like cry over. But I can't control it. It's like my whole mind and body is just going out of control. And I was having these really quick deja vu, weird dream-like flashes. But that's the thing, they were so quick and they didn't build up that I could get through them quite easily. I know after a certain amount of them, I did get a little emotional, but gosh, nothing compared to the huge ones where I completely go somewhere else. So they would happen, they were happening quite frequently, but it's like they really wanted to come out, but they would like hit a wall or something and then gone in an instant. So I would just stop every now and then and just, but it was like a split second and then gone. If I wasn't on these medications right there, I would have probably went to the ER. They were gonna be bad yesterday. Really, really bad. So I'm putting my dosage up, and maybe these little things will stop altogether. I'm just excited that something is actually helping. Wow. If I really think about it and think about my whole life with this, I've always had stuff for anxiety, so I would always go for them, and I still do. I still go for Ativan or something when they're happening. But if I look at my whole life, there was nothing that really helped, and you know that Ativan or Xanax or whatever is going to tone them down, or it's going to make me react easier to them, but it's not going to stop them. And I think this carbamazepine is the first thing ever in my entire life that's really felt like it's stopping them. Which is wonderful. I'm very excited, although I'm stoned all the time. Hopefully I'll get used to the side effects and they'll go away. Really dizzy a lot, but it's not too bad. I'm just extremely tired and dizzy off and on. So if I want to get rid of one thing, I have to take on another thing. But which one is worse? This is definitely not worse. than the actual seizures. So I'll take the medication over the seizures. Anyway, I'm pretty excited. It's just freaky. Yesterday freaked me out quite a bit, waking up feeling like that. I wish that someone could just, like, tell me exactly what is going on. I won't see a neurologist for who knows, I don't know how long. But my family doctor is doing everything he can in the meantime, so I feel a lot better than I did a few weeks ago, that's for sure. Someone at my door. Gotta go.